Problem number 4, draw the shear and moment diagram of the beam shown. So first thing that we are going to do here is to compute for the reactions and the support. So for, as we can see here, we have a uniformly distributed load over the span AC. So we compute for the resultant of the load. The resultant is acting at the centroid, wherein the centroid can be found at the midspan of the beam. And the resultant of the uniformly distributed load, it is just the area of the rectangle. So we have here the intensity of 10 kN per meter and the length of 10 meters. So we have here 100 kN. This 100 kN here can be found at the midspan. So if the total span is 10 meters, so meaning this is equal to 5 meters. In order for us to compute for the value of the reaction at C, so what we are going to do is to summate moment at point A. So we have here summation of moment at A is equal to 0, taking the clockwise rotation as positive. For the 80 kN load here, it will rotate clockwise, that is positive, multiplied by the moment arm, which is 2 meters. The resultant of the uniformly distributed load, 100 kN, that would rotate clockwise, plus 100, multiplied by the moment arm, that is half of the length of the beam, which is 5 meters, minus the RC here, which will rotate counterclockwise, multiplied by the distance to the point A, which is equal to 10 meters, is equal to 0. So solving for the value of the RC, so we have here 80 times 2 plus 100 times 5 minus 10x. And this is equal to 0. Shift solved equals, and we have here 66 kN. So RC is equal to 66 kN. And since positive yung lumabas na sagot, meaning tama yung assumption natin that RC is directed upward. In order for us to compute for the value of RA, so what we are going to do is to summate forces vertical is equal to 0, taking the upper direction as positive. So we have here RA, directed upward, minus the load 80, which is directed downward, and the resultant of the uniformly distributed load, which is 100, so that's negative also. And the RC here is directed upward, so plus RC is equal to 0. But we already computed for the value of RC, so this RC here is 66 kN. So solving for the value of RA, then we have RA, so that's x, minus 80 minus 100 plus 66 is equal to 0. Shift solve equals, then we have here 114 kN. So this is equal to 114 kN. Since we have the positive answer, meaning the assumption for RA, which is directed upward, is correct. Okay, since we already had computed for the value of the RA and the RC, so we are now going to draw the shear and moment diagram using the area method. So for the shear, we have the shear at point A is equal to the reaction at A, which is equal to 140. So meaning here we have 114, and the shear at point B is equal to 114 minus the area between A and B. And the area between A and B is this. No, so ito yung area na to. Yung area na to has the magnitude of 10, no, which is the height, and of course the length of 2. So 10 times 2, so this is 20 kilonewton. So this is equal to 114 minus 20. So yung shear natin at point B is equal to 114 minus 20. So we have 114 minus 20 is equal to 94 kilonewton. So we have here 94 kilonewton. So this is equal to 94. Since this is degree 0, so dito we have the degree 1, no, or the linear equation, no? Okay. So i-denote ko to, yung shear na to sa B, yung 94 as the left. Kasi kung nandito tayo sa mismo sa point B, sa left na portion, so that is 94 before, ha, before siya nakarating ng point B, kumbaga nasa bandang 1.99999, hindi pa siya nakarating ng 2. So wala pa itong 80 kilonewton. No, kapag siya ay nakasampan na doon sa may B, so that is 2 equal to 2 or 2.0001. That is the shear at point B, no, sa right naman. And of course, that is equal to 94 kilonewton minus yung load na 80. Kasi itutulak, no, si 94 ay ibababa ng 80 kilonewton na concentrated load. So we have here the shear is equal to 94 minus 80 is equal to 14 kilonewton. So ito ay bababa ng 14, no? So magiging 14 na lang siya dyan. And for the shear at point C, so that is yung last na value natin ng shear at point B, maminusan natin ng area between B and C. So yung area between B and C is this. Ito yun, yung area ng rectangle na to. And that area, so yung shear natin at C, so yung shear natin at B, at point B is 14 kilonewton minus yung area ng C, so that's 10 multiplied by 8. So itong area nito is equal to 10 times 8, which is equal to 80. Yung magnitude lang to multiplied by the distance. So we have here yung shear natin sa C is equal to 14 minus 80, and that is equal to negative 66. So we have here negative 66. So dito we have negative 66 kilonewton. Okay, so kukonnect lang natin ito by a line, kasi makikita natin dito sa load diagram natin we have degree 0. So dito sa shear diagram natin we have degree 1. So kukonnect lang natin siya gamit yung line. Okay? So this is now our shear diagram. Okay, so lilipat tayo sa moment. For the moment at point A, so we have here 0, kasi wala namang area dyan, so 0. The moment at point B is just equal to the area 1. Sino si area 1? So ito yung area 1 natin, yung trapezoid. And of course, i-denote natin to, itong area na to as area 2, and this is area 3. Okay? So, for the area 1, since we have here a trapezoid, so we have average of the bases lang to multiplied by the height, right? So we have average of the base, we have 114 and 94 over 2 multiplied by the height, which is 2, no? So ito kasi ay 2, ito ay 114, at ito naman yung height na to is 94. So average ng dalawang base multiplied by this height. Okay, so yung moment natin at point B is equal to 114 plus 94. So cancel lang naman kasi yung 2. So we have here 208. So this is 208 kilonewton meter. the value of our moment here is equal to 208 kilonewton meter. Now, from the idea pa rin ng dyix, no? So, dyix, since we have here decreasing, bakit siya decreasing? Kasi from 140 naging 94, no? Bibend natin yung y-axis. So, if this palagi yung nasa left, no? Ito kasi i-connect natin at saka to, yung palagi, no? Itong kaliwa ay palaging origin. So, yung point na pagkukunika natin ay nasa quadrant 1. So, therefore, this is the y-axis. Dy is to bend the y-axis kasi decreasing. So, we have to bend the y-axis and this is our curvature. Ayan. Now, so, this location here is the location of the zero shear and papangalanan natin itong distance x. No? Kasi dito natin makikita yung location ng maximum moment. So, in order for us to compute for the value of x, we'll make use of the ratio and proportion. So, previously, dun sa shear and moment function natin ay madali natin siyang nakuha gamit yung equation ng shear natin for the signal BC. So in here, we'll be using the ratio and proportion. Since this is 8 and this is 8 minus x. Okay? So by ratio and proportion, we have here x is to 14. Ito yun, yung triangle na maliit. That is equal to 8 minus x over this one, that's 66. So, neglect lang natin yung sign. So, computing for the value of x here, then we have x is 214. This is equal to 8 minus x is 266. Shift, solve, equals, and we have here 1.4. So, this is equal to 1.4. No? So, since may distance tayo dito, ay pwede na natin makompute yung area B. So, for the moment at pangalanan natin tong D, no? So, point B. So, yung moment natin at point B is equal to the area, this is equal to the moment at point B plus the area 2. So, yung moment ng point B natin, that's 208. Yung area natin sa 2 is area of the triangle. So, that is 1 half. The base is x, which is equal to 1.4. And the height is the magnitude of the shear. That's 14. So, we have here the moment at B is equal to 208 plus 1 half times 1.4 times 14. And we have here 217.8. So, 217.8 kilonewton meter. So, this is 217.8 kilonewton meter. Now, this is decreasing. So, ito pa rin gagamitin natin. Decreasing, so bibend natin yung y-axis. So, ito yung origin. Ito kasi ay nasa quadrant 1, no? So, bibend natin yung y-axis. So, therefore, this is the curvature. Yan. This is degree 2 curve, no? So, this is degree 2 curve. Degree 2 din to. Kasi degree 1 tayo dyan and degree 1 tayo dito. Okay? So, let us now compute for the moment at point C. So, that is just equal to the moment at point B. Maminusan lang natin ang area 3 kasi yung area 3 natin dito is negative. So, if x is equal to 1.4, yung 8 minus x is equal to, then yung 8 minus x is equal to 8 minus 1.4. That is equal to 6.6. So, this is 6.6. Now, the moment at C is equal to the moment at B, which is 217.8 minus area 3, that's 1 half. The base is 8 minus X, which is equal to 6.6 meters. So, we have here 6.6 multiplied by the magnitude of the shear, that's 66. So, yung moment at C natin is equal to 217.8 minus 1 half times 6.6 times 66. And that is equal to 0. So ibig sabihin napasara natin yung ating moment diagram. So pag hindi ito nagsara, magtaka ka na. Ibig sabihin may mali ka. Okay, so this is increasing. Ibig sabihin, we bend, no? Increasing, we bend the x-axis. So, since this is the point on the left, at dito natin siya i-coconnect, ito ngayon ay nasa quadrant 4. So, ito ngayon yung x-axis natin. So, ibibend natin yung x-axis, meaning this will be our curvature. So, this is now the moment diagram. And kung compare natin to dun sa shear and moment diagram natin, sa previous solution natin, using the shear and moment function, pareho lang naman ito. No? So, again, the possible questions na pwede natin sagutin dito, the maximum positive shear is equal to 114 kN, the maximum negative shear is 66 kN. And, hindi ko pala nasabi kanina, itong 66 na to ay ipapaklose siya nitong 66 upward para magkaroon ka na ng zero shear at the point. The value of the maximum moment is 217.8, which is located at x, no? Ang x natin is 1.4. 1.4 from this point. So, kung yung tanong, what is the distance of the location ng maximum moment and the zero shear from the point A? So, mag-plus 2 lang tayo. So, 1.4 plus 2, so that's 2.4. And if we are going to compare this with our previous solution, so pareho naman, no? So, yung x natin is 3.4. Okay?